With JDK Flight Recorder and Mission Control, we can continuously collect detailed runtime information about our JDK and Java applications. So this helps us in analyzing and profiling our applications. So I've covered Flight Recorder and Mission Control in my previous videos in very detailed manner. So in this video, I will be showing how to do flight recording from Mission Control. So Flight Recorder is inbuilt and free to use since Java 11. And Mission Control, you have to download first from this website, jdk.java.net/jmc. So I have one Java application for which I'll be doing flight recording. So in this application, I'm creating 100 threads and each thread is putting 1 million values in the list. You can click here to start using JDK Mission Control. And this is your JVM browser. Here you will see all the Java processes running in your system. So I'm running my application now. You can see that you have memory example here in JVM browser. So when you expand this, you will have two options. The first is mbean server and second is flight recorder. So when you click on this, you can start the flight recording. Okay, I'll click on here. Here, first you can rename your recording. Let's say memory example first, and then you can choose which type of recording you want to do in your application. So first is time fixed recording. By default, it is 1 minute. And in continuous recording, again, you have to specify the buffer size and age for the buffers. So I'll select time fixed recording for now. And when you click next, you can see you have other options also. For example, let's say in garbage collector, you have option normal or all events of off. On thread dump, if you want to take every 60 seconds. So for now, I'll just click on finish and I'll do the recording for 1 minute. So in the bottom of screen, you can check the progress here. You can see that the recording is progressing in this section of the screen. For fixed duration, when the time is elapsed, JMC will only open the flight recording file. So Mission Control has opened our JFR file and you can see that it has already performed some automated analysis to identify any obvious problems present in our recorded run. So all the benchmarks are divided into two parts. On the left side, you can see that the problems in your Java application. On the right side, the problem with the JVM internals. All the benchmarks with the green tiles, you don't have to worry much. For orange and red color of the tiles, you should have a close look. So if you click any of the tile, it will give you detailed analysis. For example, in garbage collection, since I'm using Java 14, so I have G1 GC as my default collector. So you can see that at least one full stop the word garbage collection occurred during this recording, you know, which is a very bad thing for our application. So in my Java application, we can see that in GC pressure, so JVM was paused 100%. During 4.648 seconds, you know, which is very huge time. Also, if I talk about VM operations, so I can see that there's a detailed analysis on that. In the environment, we can see that we have too many competing processes. So this is it. So now we'll dig into individual processes that we have. So on the left side, you can see that we have an outline for our JFR file. So first is you have Java applications, then JVM internals, then environment. Okay, so they have already categorized the different metrics. Now first let's go to Java application. So it will show you high level dashboard of overall health of the application. So major subsystem of the Java applications, you know, we can see here is CPU usage, heap usage, method profiling and allocation. We can see that this orange vertical lines are for the GC pauses. So here we had 126 milliseconds, but here we can see that this is 2.2 second. Apart from that, in CPU usage, we can see that we have you know, usage of CPU, my machine usage versus my JVM usage. We can see JVM was consuming 39.4% here. For our heap usage, we can see that it is continuously increasing at from this point, then our GC halt is happening, and then again it is going up and up and up. For every GC, it reduces some memory and then again it shoots up. So this is pretty helpful in profiling your application, and you'll get to know where exactly your application is failing. Then we can go on to the further subsystem. So I think our application is consuming too much memory. So I think we can move to memory now. So in the memory section, you have the complete chart about the memory. So you can see the garbage collection phases are, you know, taking too much time. Then we have used heap, which is constantly increasing over the time. Then the allocation we have here, we can see different allocations and different sizes of allocations. So next, I think we can also get the method level profiling from here. So which tells you top packages and top classes and the stack trace for each method. You can check the count for which method was called in our system. For example, let's say I'm talking about JDK internal.math. For a particular method, I can check that, you know, the count stack trace along with count. Then we can move to exceptions also. So if you see that we had, you know, this much count of exceptions for no such method error, we didn't have any custom exception here, so we'll not be able to see them. So these are all system exceptions that occurred during our application run. Then we can also get thread dumps. So we selected a 60-second thread dump. And so if you click, you have the complete thread details. So I created around 100 threads. And so if you click any of the threads, you'll get to know the complete detail about the thread, its state, you can check, and how much time it elapsed, if it was blocking something or not. So this is really helpful. So we also see, you know, GC threads also. So we had around 10 to 12 GC threads as a daemon threads which were running. So this is about the Java application. When I go to JVM internals, so the most important thing is garbage collection. So garbage collection tells you the longest pauses. In this graph, you can see what were the longest pauses, and the collector name was G1 full. And we can also check, you know, weak references, soft references, and phantom references in this particular run. So we can see that for this much time, our application was paused. And then we have different pause phases. And for metaspace, you can get to know here in this tab. So below here, we can see complete graph about all the details, about the longest pause, sum of pauses. Then if I want to see the thread activities and then pause phases, you know, all these details are available here. Then we have compilations also here. So this is another major subsystem of JVM, so which is a JIT compiler. And if I check here compilations, I can see how much is the compilation code size. And with large applications, we have many compiled methods, and this area of memory can be exhausted, resulting in performance issues. So we should take a look at this also. Then in class loading section, we can check how much classes are loaded. So we have a class loading statistics. We can see there was delegating class loader and different block sizes, chunk sizes. In VM operations also, we get to know, you know, different operations that performed and for how much time. So this is pretty helpful. In this way, you can cover each and every detail regarding your Java application and JVM. So these JFR files can also be read programmatically from the Java code. For example, you're only concerned about the memory parameter. Okay, so what you can do is you can read this JFR and you can apply filter for memory parameters. You can see that we can load our recording file and we can filter based on different events. So when you start continuous recording for your application, you have to dump recording at some point of time. Okay, so that you can do here by right clicking on this. So you can select dump recording data and you can just click finish. Okay, it will name your file whatever you would have given there. And you have to just click on this finish. So it will dump the snapshot and it will open that and give you automated results. So this is it from JDK mission control and flight recording demo. So stay tuned for more videos. Thanks.